his company ensemble, the Washington Improv Theater. Knox, let's give him a warm
welcome.
Yeah, welcome. Knox!
We are Knox! And to get started, all we need from you is a suggestion, preferably not a food item. Wow!
Do you want to do it?
You guys
want to
do it? You guys want to do it?
Good!
Just to be clear.
Food item, everybody's just like, oh, food.
Oh, I had that taco or that Dunbury bowl. What's up?
Uvula.
Uvula?
Uvula.
Awesome suggestion. Thank you very much.
Hello. I know most of you know me as a vocal songstress and entertainer, Wanda LaRue. I just want to thank you for coming here tonight. It's so hard
after being Omaha's number one cabaret review singer. It's so hard, my fans, to tell you that I've been lip-syncing. I've been lip-syncing since day one. Oh, God. I hear you asking, murmuring, Wanda, why? Why would you be high?
Why?
Or a dead!
Oh God! Seriously, why?
I hear you. When I moved to Omaha as a young lady 15 years ago, I knew I had to make ends meet somehow, but I had no.
I'll get to a point. Okay, all right. Trevor. Just wanted to be sure.
Trevor.
Okay.
Is that my ex-husband, Trevor?
Yes.
I have a restraining order, Trevor. You need to be at least 50 yards away.
I'm 51. I checked it out earlier.
As I was saying, life was hard. I need to make ends meet. And somebody asked me to sing in the cabaret, but my friends, I cannot carry, as they say, a tune. So I've had my sister, Jessica LaRue, behind the curtain for me all these years, singing my songs, my greatest hits. You liked my version of Edge of 17? Well, you liked Jessica's version of Edge of 17, okay? We're all Stevie Nicks fans here. Well, I'm telling you this because Jessica has moved to New York to pursue her career, and I am no longer going to be on the stages of Omaha. So, farewell. Farewell.
Arrivederci.
Arrivederci. Look, Phil, I need to go out there. Pretend you're me and give my kid a pep talk.
Give your kid a pep talk. Got it.
I'm not a very good father. So if you could just like... It's the fourth time you struck out. You better reevaluate what you're doing on this team, mister.
What is reevaluating?
Hey, I tried to play with him in the backyard. I'm just not a good ball player. Just like put this towel over your head and give him what he needs.
Should I do the same mannerisms as you?
Yeah, I mean, so.
Should I say mannerisms where you kind of just box your arms in right to your chest?
Yeah. I mean, do I really need to?
Yeah, you do. You do.
All right, well, just. If that kid, he needs to succeed. Just put a reference. What's your kid's name again? It's Kyle.
Kyle, got it.
Hey Kyle, it's me, your dad.
Whatever.
I mean, I get it. Whatever, whatever, man. You know? Whatever for me. I'm just wearing this towel over my head. No big deal. I don't really care.
That's not a towel. It's a floor mat.
I was told it was a towel. So, Jake, I'm cool with that. Whatever, whatever.
Whatever.
Whatever. Hey.
Yeah, Dad.
I thought you did a pretty good job out there.
Struck out four times.
Doesn't matter, though.
They brought up and they named striking out four times to Kyle.
Kyle, you still got up there, and you still have something named after you.
Yeah. Failure. Like a series of failures.
Some people don't even have anything named after them.
Because they didn't fail four times in a row.
Right, but guess what? Nobody remembers their name, Kyle. Kyle, I'm proud of you regardless of what you do. You know why?
What, Dad?
Because you're my son and I love you.
I feel like this would be more powerful if delivered without a bath mat on your head.
Can you give your old dad a minute?
Sure.
Like a quick timeout.
Sure, Dad.
Good job. Good job. Hey, why don't you tell me this was a floor mat?
Beautiful sunset.
Nope.
Hey, Lucas, do we have to take your brother everywhere we can?
Yep.
You're not for it, but...
Baby. Yeah. You know, when my mom died, she said, take care of Bill. He's simple, but he doesn't cause that much trouble. So yeah, he's gonna come along with us whenever, but you know what? You just look at me and you just
What is it?
I don't know.
You just melt any anxiety I have. It's like it comes up to say something and it's like, you knock it down.
It's like pheromones, but like emotional. Oh, that's what it is. Yeah. It's our connection. No?
Yeah.
This is where we were when we first met on our first date. And you said, Can you just go get us some ice cream? I'd like a rocket pop.
Rocket missile?
Nope.
Italian ice.
We gotta get rid of my brother.
Yeah.
He's a disaster, babe. He's a disaster.
Wait, are you on board?
Thanks, Bill.
Rocket pop.
Thanks.
Rocket missile. Who knew that was a thing?
Right? This guy did.
Yeah, and sherbet on a string.
Did you absolutely have to get that?
Yeah.
Are there other options?
No,
it was the last one, he insisted.
It came with a little ring, so I don't have to actually hold the string. Did you want a little bit?
It's dripping on my husband.
Husband. It's fine. I'll be right over here. Enjoying the sunset.
Yeah, it's good, right?
Awesome again.
Rocket missile's a hot choice. Scribber.
Yeah, sometimes.
It's
not a real missile dumbed down. You can't just throw.
I wish it was a real missile.
Oh, babe, let's just focus on this. Let's just focus.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1. It works.
Yeah.
Mel Robbins was right.
Make sure you don't want to tell him that. Sure, but on string.
I just want to say that I love you. And I'm pregnant.
This is phenomenal.
Yeah. We're going to be parents.
This is going to be so great. You know what? The baby can have my room.
No, we didn't want that.
No, yes, you, no, perfect. It's perfect.
So you'll move out?
No, there's a, oh no, there's a pullout in the action, in the family room, of course. I'll just sleep on the pullout. And you don't need an office. Who needs an office?
Things.
Well, hurry up, so they get started without us. I'm not gonna be with you.
Hun, you think I look better in my, my brown spandex? Or are those just yours?
I'm sorry, I couldn't hear you, but I'm upstairs, and I was getting dressed. What was it?
Do you think I look better in my brown spandex pants or my jorts?
Your jorts! Jorts. Jorts. Bill.
All right.
Bill, you're very sweaty.
I'm nervous. When we went last time...
Nobody took your keys, I
know. Yeah, I know.
I know, nobody took your keys. It was very unorthodox. And I went and did a little threesome with Sherry Torkelson and Bill, you know, what's his face? Bill, you know.
I know.
Bill Halverson. You know, the tall Scandinavian fellow.
I mean, I like brushed up and I cleaned myself up and I had my best jorts on and no one just...
Are those your best jorts?
Well, yeah.
No, I pressed your best jorts.
Dad, can you throw the ball with me?
Son, I'm busy with your mother.
Oh.
Look, I pressed your jorts. Perfect for the sex party. See, I'm thinking ahead. Sheila's always thinking ahead.
Thanks.
What do you think of this mesh bodysuit?
You look amazing, as always.
Look, it's crotchless.
ladies and gentlemen, we'll be taking off in about 10 minutes. We just want to thank you for flying American Airlines. I'm Captain Smith. With me, co-captain Rogers. How's your night?
It's good.
Cool.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, whatever.
Yeah, right. Hey man, you want to launch, want to fly us out of here tonight? Do you want me to do it? I want you to pull a Kyle.
Yeah, sure, I'd be happy to. I do not even want to come close to pulling a Kyle.
It's in the book, man.
Yeah. Did you hear about that other flight?
Which one?
It was the, oh my god. Was it a United flight? Did they pull the Kyle?
Oh shit, I think you're right.
Yeah.
It's 111 going into Baltimore. Took them 4 times to try to land it.
I just circled. I couldn't imagine. I didn't go for that. I would have thought, like, hey, are we almost out of gas?
Right?
Like, are we at that danger point?
You just freaked me out.
I'm sorry.
You're
cards. Well, you said the Kyle, and now I'm all in my head about it.
Get out of here.
What if it takes me 3 times? What if it takes me 5?
Nope,
I don't want somebody to name something after me.
Tower, this is Tower to Flight 1313. What are y'all doing?
freaking out a little bit. We're freaking out a little bit in here.
Yeah, we're freaking out. Did you hear that, over?
Yeah, I got it. He's got a mic. what?
Hey, Captain, Co-Captain, just... the freaking out thing was just broadcast to the entire...
what?
The entire... all the passengers. So, I'm just gonna close this little door, okay?
Yeah, could have knocked it, let us know.
Okay.
Well, it was closed.
I've been a flight attendant for 47 years. You don't tell me to knock.
I'm sorry, Doris.
I was a flight attendant when you were shitting yourself, Bill. Okay? As for you, I have sons who are older than you, okay? I'm dealing with 400 freaked out people back there. Get us the fuck out of Baltimore.
Captain,
I have dildos older than you.
Why do you always have to compare and measure things based on age of things that you have or own or have given birth to, Dolores?
Yeah, so you know what? I own a full-length slip that I'm wearing right now. That I wore to your christening. Your mother and I were flight attendants together when this was Qantas Airlines. So if you could just get us the fuck out of Baltimore, okay?
I'm gonna roger that.
All right. I'm gonna put on my dance goes, and I'm gonna start the circus. As soon as we get the fuck out of Baltimore. Okay.
BWI Tower, just wondering when you guys are gonna get the fuck out of Baltimore.
Yeah.
I'm gonna roger that.
Terry?
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, Terry? Yeah, I'm right here.
I'm right here.
Oh, God.
Terry, how you been?
Oh, I miss you.
I miss the way you smell, Terry.
I miss the way you feel at like 5 o'clock in the morning after we've been
spending
all night in Omaha.
I love that smell that you have. It's like the smell of Hotel 6 soap and like your musk. Do you remember that summer of 91, Terry?
Oh.
Do you remember it?
Of course, I kind of just said of course.
Trevor!
Passengers will be leaving Baltimore shortly.
Just a sec.
I remember the first time I saw you dance.
This is Val Airlines. We're going to Vicky a bit. Hurry up. Get the fuck out of Baltimore.
You are now 27th in line. Fuck you.
Is what you signed up for?
Get that ginger ale of those. I'll get this plane out.
You get this plane out of here?
I guess.
You always knew how to land one in a tight spot, Terry.
I know how to line them up.
Yeah. All right, you want kisses? All right. Now I'm gonna go put on my Dansko clogs. For comfort!
Are those regulation?
Don't explain flight attendant regulations to me, Bill, okay? Okay. Oh, let me show you a little something. It's a little pamphlet I carry around. Oh, is that Gloria Steinem? Is that Gladys? Is this us? For the rights of flight attendants in 1978?
Okay. Just because you're my godmother doesn't mean I have to flip that.
If I have to go tell your mother that you were disrespectful, you will not like it. Now I'm going to go put on my dance go clocks. Don't make that face.
He's not making that face, is he, Mary?
Terry, it's Gladdy, Gladdy, Poopy Poo. Uh-huh. Yeah.
My forever sunset.
Oh, I could watch the sun rise in your eyes in Oklahoma City.
I'm on like 3 hours of sleep and I got to transfer to Copenhagen.
Nobody gives a shit.
These two shitbirds are pulling a Kyle trying to get out of Baltimore.
Hey, nobody's pulling a Kyle here.
We just got that out of his head. So, Tear.
Yeah.
Terry Bear.
Uh-huh.
Terry Bear, Boomy Boom.
Really?
Yeah. So you ever, you leave that wife of yours yet?
No.
God,
God damn it. God damn it. You know what? You know what? Nobody appreciates a woman in her sexual prime. All right, Terry, you're dead to me.
I love you.
You're 78 years old.
Don't do me.
Everybody, my name's Dave. Dave Harney.
Hey, Dave.
You've probably seen a lot of me. I travel in just about every airport. My whole idea is segments. I'm trying to constantly get new and different segments from time to time, place to place. You might think, you know, for being able to get to board first, you know, to getting all these segments, to getting all these miles, to getting all these points, what do you do with them?
What do you do?
Take more flights?
That is accurate.
A magazine subscription?
But you would think with all the luxury and with all the upgrades to first class and all the champagne and everything that I get for free, that I would be able to just say, hey, I have enough. Every airport that I'm in, I steal a package of peanut M&Ms. I don't care what airport. If it's Atlanta, Dallas-Fort Worth, fuck Dallas-Fort Worth. I would find a newsstand, one of the generic newsstands that they have, and I would steal a package of peanut M&Ms. Why? Because I'm always being given to. I never get to take.
Take it.
And this is my one opportunity to take. It doesn't matter. If I'm there, I'll look somebody right in the eye. I will look somebody right in the eye. As I'm taking that, pick it up, look at them, wave as I back out, because I want them to know it's a total dick move and 100% a power play. So if you see me in an airport, at any point in time, find me. Find me, let's make a power move together. Yeah, I want you to get those M&Ms.
I have a nut allergy.
They just want the greens. The tour rider said just the greens. There are two greens in this bowl.
Okay. Don't be here in like 15 minutes.
I know.
He says that there's more than just the greens. He's gonna flip the fuck out.
Is it possible he's colorblind? Because it's...
Come down, I'll check his file.
Look at this. Look at this, Frank. It's two greens and just all the other colors, and I'm gonna get fired because... Sarah McLachlan has a rider that she only wants green M&Ms, okay? Is she colorblind?
No. It says no.
Is it?
She's coming.
Fuck! She is so mean! No, you don't know, guys. I was working here.
Hello, Sarah. How are you?
Hi! Welcome to Providence, Rhode Island.
Is that my fault?
Because there were only two. I opened so many bags of peanut M&Ms. Oh my God.
Josh Groban, the opening act.
Please forgive me.
Oh, so sorry.
Please, I'm so sorry. I'm
so sorry. Please. If anyone has to die, let it be me.
Please.
Yes.
I'm a huge fan. I own your live album. I own all of your albums, please.
I can't stand
so
your
sorry.
Music. I can say.
Finish the bowl.
I'm sorry.
Finish the bowl of M&Ms.
How do you mean?
Eat them all.
I have a nut allergy.
That seems like a you problem.
No, I'll die.
Oh.
My face will swell up and my lips will swell up and my throat. You're a monster. You're a monster, Sam. I'm glad that why. No.
EpiPen? Where's your EpiPen?
It's right here.